Word of Life with Reverend Mitzi Gibson is made possible in part by Grace Christian Center, Margaret's Beauty Salon, Holly's AC and Refrigeration, and Harold and Elsie Broussard.
Welcome to the Word of Life once with you, your servant, Mitzi Gibson. It is a pleasure to know that when we begin to speak the Word of God, and you who are listening or you who are watching the program, it touched not only you, but it touched me again, because not only I'm speaking the Word by the power of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus, but as I speak the Word, it kind of refreshes me again and bring me more that I already had received before when I was putting this teaching together by the power of the Holy Spirit. So I know that this teaching is going to help a lot of us, because the more that you hear it, the best that you, beginning to put together in your heart, in your mind, the thing that God has for us that sometimes, escape from our mind, or skip from, because we are too busy. But I hope that this time, everybody be alert to do and receive what God has for you. I'm going to be reading the promise that Abraham for us, starting in the Old Testament, and I continue to go to get into Christ Jesus, the one who has blessed us abundantly beyond imagination. In the book of Genesis, chapter 12, I'm going to be reading, to begin, verse 1-3. Now, in Aram, the Lord said to Abram, go for yourself, for your own advantage, away from your country, from all the relatives that you have, and from your father's house, to the land that I will show you. Now, this is what really, really, really it is. Has to be faith, because he's listening to the voice of God. He's telling, get out of the city where you live in, or the nation that you are. Get away from your cousin, nephew, nieces, friends. Get away from your house and your father as well. I mean, let me tell you this. Thank you, Holy Father. This is personal, okay? When I was in my country, that I was getting ready to come to the United States for the first time, I was really nervous, because I was leaving behind my whole entire family. And when you have grown with your whole family, I mean, you feel like one part of you is leaving, but the whole part of you stay, because you feel like, how it's going to be? It's a nation that I never been, you know. I have my husband, my child, but I was excited. I'm not going to lie. I was excited because it was something new. It was something that we always like to, you know, at least I like to travel. So I was excited, but when the moment of the truth came that I was packing and they came to pack all the furniture and everything, I said, oh my God, I start tearing. I said, this is more real than what I thought it was. So I can't compare myself now. I brought to my memory that he tell him, get away from all your friends, your school friends, everything that you have in the past from the beginning that you was born. And now you have to go to a place that you didn't even know. At least I knew where I was coming. I know that I was coming to El Paso, Texas. But over here, he said, I'm going to give you a nation. But he didn't mention the name of the nation. He just told us, I'm going to give you a nation, you know. And I said to myself, wow, now I feel like if my husband would have said to me, we're going to go to the United States. And I would have said, where to? He said, I don't know. I would say, hey, what do you mean you don't know? You have to know where we're going. You say, well, we will stop wherever. I'm gonna get nervous and say, hey, listen, you take me from my family and everything, and you say that you don't know where we're going? I will be a little nervous. Of course, I have to obey him because he's my husband. But I will not be too happy because I say, what's going to happen? And one child, because we will have one child. But over here, he's telling, I say, the same thing that he has. And you know, amazing, everything in life is repetition. It's repetition because how many of you that are watching this program, you have left your country, your family, also to come to the United States or go to Germany or go to wherever God has sent you. That you live in, the nation that you are, Korea, China, you know, all these places. It's a similarity, the same thing. And then, but he said, God is God, he said, and I will make. Now, let me tell you again, I was not a Christian. When I was coming to the United States, I was not a Christian. So I didn't know anything about God. I didn't know anything about his voice. I didn't know anything. The only voice I knew that was going to bring me to the United States, it was the voice of my husband. And that, now that I'm reading this, it's kind of scary now. But then I was excited. But over here, I say, my God, he had to go to a place that he don't even know where he's going. But God keeps telling him, and I will make you a great nation. That's a promise. Remember this. I will make you a great nation, and I will bless you with abundant increase of favors. Not only he's taking him to another country, another place, but he has the assurance, the promise that God is going to bless him with abundant increase of favor. Now, this is increase of favor. Can you imagine that? He doesn't say this is, I'm going to bless you money or houses or nothing like that. He said, I'm going to bless you with increase of favor. Wow. If you have favor, wherever you walk, you are blessed. Because everybody got out of the way to help you. Because you have favor. And the favor comes from God. And God touched the heart of the people to give you what you need. So this is getting more interesting to me because he said favors. He didn't say, I'm going to bless you money and nothing like that. He said, I give you nations, but and then I'm going to bless you with favors. I make you, now he said, I make you famous and distinguished. Hello. This is beautiful. He's going to pull it out of the house. So, you know, Abraham was not losing absolutely nothing. He was gaining. He was gaining because now he was going to receive, he's going to be famous. He's going to have a nation, be blessed with blessings and favor. And then on top of everything, praise God, he said, I make your name famous and distinguished. And you will be a blessing, dispensing good to others. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. So that, you know, I have read this a lot, and I read the Bible a lot, and I know this. But, you know, it seemed to me like today, right, even as I read it right now, I see the faith that Abraham had, the faith that he had. In that time, he called it Abraham. So the faith, the great faith, because he was dependent on a voice that he had never seen God, but a voice talking to him. And then on top of everything, listen to this, blessed with blessing and favors. His name famous and distinguished. I will bless him and I will bless those blessing you and dispensing to God to be good to you. And I will bless those who bless you, confer prosperity or happiness upon you. And curse, now that's the part that's very lonely, kind of sad, but it's true. Curse him who cursed you or use insolent language toward you. In you will all the families and kindreds of the earth be blessed, and by you they will bless themselves. Over here you have everything that you needed to be living a happy, very expectant everyday life. Every day is going to be better and better and better and better. Now, to confirm it, he said, he was talking to Abraham. Now, to confirm it, that he said to descend, that you descend, and I'm going to give you everything. I'm going to be reading now in Genesis 35. He's talking now, but this time he's talking to, it was Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So we go now to Jacob. And God said, and God said to Jacob, arise. I want you to arise. The same thing that he told the father Abraham, I want you to arise. And God, in distinctly visible manifestation, appeared to Jacob again when he came out of the Padan Aram and declared blessing on him. Again, God said to him, your name is Jacob, supplanter. You shall not be called Jacob any longer, but Israel shall be your name. So he called him Israel, contending with God. Remember that he fought with God, and God allowed him to win. God allowed it. And God said to him, I am God Almighty. Be fruitful and multiply. A nation and company of nations shall come from you, and kings shall be born of you, of your stock. The land which I give it to your father Abraham and Isaac, I will give it to you and to your descendant. That's what we enter, your descendant. We are the descendant of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Now, Jacob, which is called Israel, we are the descendant also there. That's the reason that I always say, I thank you for the blessing of Abraham and, Jacob, Isaac and Jacob, because Israel is the last one. So we see over here, I'm going to bless you and all your descendants. The God descended, he said, then God ascended from him in the place where he was talking to him. So we see that God was confirming to Israel, because he changed his name, that every blessing that he promised to his father and his brother, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, everything was fulfilled. Now, when we are going to have all this blessing, when we're going to receive what God had promised Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, now call it Israel. Well, when we be born again, that's when we receive all the blessing that God has promised to us. And we're going to be reading now in the book of Ephesians. That's where the beginning that to show all the promise that God has for us as a descendant, a part of Abraham. In the book of Ephesians chapter 1, I'm going to be reading verse 1 and 3. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Father. And in fact, I'm going to skip the first verse because it's something simple. But I'm going to go to verse 2. And it says, my grace, God's unmerited favor and spirit of peace, which means peace with God and harmony, unity, and undisturbedness, be yours from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the blessing that one of the disciples was speaking to the people of Israel. Now, this is what touched us now. May blessing, praise, and elevation be an elegy to the God our Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah, who has blessed us in Christ. The Father of God has blessed us in Christ Jesus with every spiritual blessing given by the Holy Spirit, blessing in the heaven realm. Even as that is in his love, God our Father, he shows us, actually pick us out for himself as his own. In Christ Jesus, before the foundation of the earth, of the world, that we shall be wholly consecrated and set apart for him. Now we see that everything has taken place. God chose us. God wants us to be part of him. Now, in the book of Galatians, I'm going to read, this is the part that I really like, because that's what shows you everything that God has for us. In the book of Galatians, chapter 3, thank you, Father, it says, verse 6 and 8, thus Abraham believed and added and trust in God, and he relied on God, and he was recounted and placed to his account a credit as righteous man, conformity to divine will and purpose of God through action. Now, and understanding this, that it is really the people who live by faith who are the true son of Abraham. Now, through faith, we have to accept that we belong to Abraham also. He's our father, ancestor. And the scripture for saying that God will justify and declare righteous, put in right standing with himself the Gentiles. We were Gentiles. We were not people of Israel. We were Gentiles. So he said now, to declare righteous as the people standing himself, the Gentile. In consequence of faith, proclaiming the gospel of Jesus Christ. So we see in then that God, through Christ Jesus, death and resurrection, has given us all the blessing that he has for us. I receive Jesus Christ as Lord and my Savior. I am the same, you know, my father, my forefather Abraham, I receive his blessing. I receive the blessing that my, you know, the son of my father Abraham, I Israel. Now, the blessing of Jesus Christ is the one that I was looking for, because that's the one that it is ours for the rest of our life. And it's greater than the blessing of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. So in Psalm 150, I'm going to be reading a very interesting declaration that it is so, so wonderful for us. It is something that you read and you just read and read and read, excuse me, and you feel like, wow, I can't believe that this is real. I can't believe that God loves us so much, but he does. He does. He loves us. That's the reason that he sent Jesus Christ to die for us. So in verse 9, in Psalm 150, say, O Israel, trust and take refuge in the Lord. Lean on him, rely on him, and be confident in him. He is their help and your shield. He's our help and our shield. Excuse me. O house of Aaron, he started with Aaron, saying, the priesthood. Trust and lean in the Lord. He is their help and their shield of the house of Aaron. And now, verse 11, you who reverently worship the Lord and fear the Lord, trust in the Lord, lean on the Lord. He is your help and your shield. Now, this is us. Verse 11 is us. You who reverently fear the Lord. Remember, he went through Israel and then through the Aaron. So now this is our part when we were born again. The Lord said, you who reverently fear the Lord, trust in the Lord and lean on him, he is your help and your shield. The same thing that he promised Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Now, we are the descendant of them, and we have been born again. And the Lord keeps on saying, the Lord has been mindful with you. He will bless us. He will bless us. He will bless us, and he will bless the house of Israel. He started with Israel again. He will bless the house of Israel. He will bless the house of Aaron, the priesthood. And he will bless those who reverentially and worship or fear the Lord. That's us. He will bless us. We have been born again. We receive Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior. Now we know that he is part of us and we are part of him. And he said, I will bless you. I will bless you, he said. Those who reverentially and worshipfully fear the Lord, both small or great. I don't care if you're poor or rich, you're small or great. I don't care if you have diploma and you don't have diploma. I don't care if you never been in school. I don't care what is your life. One thing I'm just going to tell you. You are blessed of God if you have received Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior. And you have everything. Everything that you have is, let me put it this way. It's going to be a very, you're probably going to say that's exaggeration, but it's not. the President of the United States, he's rich, he have everything, and he's a Christian also. Now, I am not sitting in the White House, but everything that God has given me, I consider greater, because it's coming from someone that never going to take it away from me. These blessings are mine forever. Now, the president, 4 years, had to get out. I don't have to get out ever. So my blessings are greater than anyone that has a high position or low position, poor, rich, or whatever. Because if you are a son of God, and you believe in him, and you have received Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior, you are rich that you can be, because God said it very clear. He said very clear, 13, I will bless those who reverently and worship and fear the Lord, both small or great. So how much do you care for the Lord? Do you really love the Lord? Do you really have a relationship with God? Do you really seek him with all your heart, all your strength, all your mind? Now, and when you're seeking him because he has given you promise that he's going to make you rich. He's going to give you everything you want. You're seeking him because everything monetarily, that's what you're looking for. If you're looking for that, you're going to get it, yes. But in my account, this is the way I see it. I have everything. He promised me in verse 13, I have everything. But that everything that I have, it can, you know, money cannot save me, help me to pay my bills and all those things. But what I try to say, the material thing is good, but it cannot save you. It cannot get you, you know, out of debt. I say spiritual debt. Now, the one that blesses you and me with everything, that's the one that I want. Because once I have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, you have, and nobody can take it away from us, that's the one that I want to have communication. Because he has promised me all the blessing, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and I have it, all what we need to do is keep on reading the Bible and learn how to obtain it, because God will never change his mind. He said that he's going to make you rich. He's going to make it rich. He's going to give you what you want, and you ask him. If you trust, you ask him, and you believe that by faith. Because remember that we had to, everything that Abraham had, it was through faith. So now we see that we need to believe that God's going to give us everything. So God is what I'm looking for. God is what I want, because if I have God and I have the Lord Jesus Christ, the rest is not important, because, you know, the one that gives me the rest is the one that is inside of me, inside of you. And not only he's giving me everything that I want, but he also is my shield and he's my buckler. He is my salvation and my protector. And that's what I look at, because if I have him that protect me from all evil, I can have all the money of the earth, but they cannot protect me from evil. But I can have him protecting me from all evil, plus I have all the blessing. So my interest is that the Lord giving me increase more and more every day, and to my children and the children with the children's children. So you see, the generations keep on going. Not only now, Mitzi Gibson going to have all the benefits of God, but my children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, I'm going to from generation, generation, generation. And why? Because faith. And like I said, to have material thing is important, but I want the one that has given me the material thing, because he is my protector, he is my God, and he's the one that's going to defend me and going to continue to pass every blessing that I have to my descendant, to my children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, great-grandchildren. Because by me having communication with God, having relationship with God, I can teach my children, my grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and they continue to teach each other, so they can have the benefit that is here in the Bible. If they don't have it, because they don't read it. I don't have it, because I don't read it. But over here, he said very clearly, I bless you. I, the Lord, bless you. I, the Lord, who made the heaven and earth, I will bless you. He said, I will give you everything you need. And I am very happy, because the one that giving me everything is my God, is my Father, is my Lord, and he lives inside of me. So what else that I want? I have it all. I have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And because I have them, not only I am safe and I'm protected, but then I can have the rest of the benefit, material thing. So remember, pay attention to the one that is the giver so you can obtain the blessing. Don't ask for the blessing. Ask for the relationship with the one that created heaven and earth, the one that protects you and plus bless you. Because he said very clearly, I will give you increase more and more every day. More and more is me every day to you and to your children and the children's children. That is the most beautiful verse that I can read after all be reading all these things. Because I know that the one that created me, the one that saved me, Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior, he saved me. And I know that I can have everything that I want if I have faith. So what I'm going to say? God, increase me in faith. I bow myself with the faith of God so I can grow in faith. And as I grow in faith, not because of the material thing, I will grow in faith with him and I will obtain everything that he has for me. Amen? So I am very happy because I have discovered that the one that made everything from the beginning with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob promises, their promises are mine now too and belong to my children and the descendants to come. If you have not received Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior, I would like you to pray this prayer with me. It said this, I am a sinner. I need salvation. And I ask you in the name of Jesus, Father God, to forgive me all the sins I have committed. I receive Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Thank you, Father God, now in the name of Jesus, that I am your child. You are my Father. Jesus is my Lord. And I thank you for the Holy Spirit that indwelling me. So everything that we have said and we have read it, remember this. The heaven is the Lord. The heaven is not only the Lord, but the earth is the Lord. And he's given to the children of men. That's the top of the cake. The heaven are the Lord's heavens, but the earth he has given to us, the children of men. So we are blessed. We have everything. We have everything. I'm telling you, it is the most beautiful. Three verses coming from the Old Testament to the New Testament. And now, remember that Jesus said, everything that is written in the book of Moses, everything that is written in the book of the prophet, and everything that is written in the book of Psalm, it shall be fulfilled. It shall be fulfilled. So I came from Old Testament, the prophet, and the Psalm. So in the name of Jesus, every word that I spoke, I claim it for me and my family, and I claim it for you that watch this program. Because we are the descendant, the one that created the universe, and he's my father, my protector, and he will maintain that descendant to my next generation to generation. God bless you. I love you. In Jesus' name, be happy.
It's the Word of Life.
The Word of Life with Reverend Mitzi Gibson is made possible in part by Grace Christian Center, Margaret's Beauty Salon, Tolly's AC and Refrigeration, and Harold and Elsie Broussard.